Hey guys, welcome back. Now in this video we're gonna talk about unofficial Lineage OS ROM based on Android 9.0 Pie. We already have working stable Android Pie ROMs for many Qualcomm triple enabled phones in the form of GSI. But this Lineage OS ROM is just a normal ROM and not the one based on GSI or semi-GSI, so obviously installation process is pretty straightforward and simple. To download this ROM, go to the XDA Thread Lineage OS webpage for MIA1. I am downloading the Lineage OS ROM and GFS package for MIA1 Tissot, and the current latest build is August 28th. So once you have downloaded it, place the ROM zip file into the internal storage of your phone. Go to custom recovery like TWRP by holding volume up and power button for MIA1. First go to wipe tab, advanced wipe, and select everything except storage options like internal storage, USB storage or micro SD card options, and swipe to confirm wipe. If you are coming from stock ROM, you need to format data because this ROM has hardware encryption issues. For this, go to wipe, format data, and type yes. Next, go back to the home screen, install tab, select the transferred Lineage OS ROM and GFS package along with TWRP recovery installer, and select the Lineage OS ROM with TWRP installer and swipe to confirm flash. Once it is done, reboot the device to recovery again. Now select the GFS package and swipe to confirm flash. And that's it, we are done with the installation process. So simple, right? And if you want to flash a custom kernel or magic for routing, you can do it, but it's up to you. Once the installation is done, reboot the phone to system. So this is the Lineage OS boot animation. Is the same animation we have seen it on previous Lineage OS ROMs. This is the initial setup screen. Let me finish setting it up. This is the default home screen with Lineage OS launcher. Everything should be working out of the box and you don't need to flash any separate fixes. Then first, let's go to system settings, about phone, and as you can see, Android version is 9 and Android security patch level is August 5, same as the Google final release build for Pixel phones. About the launcher features, if you long press on empty space of the home screen, you can change the home settings, add widgets, and change wallpapers. By default, you are not getting on-screen navigation bar because MIA1 has hardware buttons. But if you want to enable the Pixel gestures, just go to settings, system, gestures, and enable swipe up on home button. And also you need magics. Now in magics, tap on 3-dot menu on the top left side. Go to module section, then flash this Android Pie navigation fix for MIA1. It will also disable your hardware buttons. And flashing the nav bar module will disable your VoLT. So if you don't care about VoLT, you can use this. Otherwise, don't use this fix. Just use the hardware buttons. About the gestures, you can swipe up on the pin or home button to get the recent menu. Long swipe will get you the app drawer. When you swipe all the open tabs to the right, you get the clear all button. In the slide down under a specific tab to open it and slide up to close it, and when you hit the app icon on open tab, you can enable the split screen mode. And finally, there is slider to switch between the open tabs. This is the notification panel and quick settings. Quick toggles are secular and style of quick setting toggles and notification is based on device theme. The ROM comes with very minimal apps. You need to install Google camera app because Snapdragon camera is not working, and with Google camera you can take pictures, shoot videos at 60 frames per second. Image stabilization is there and portrait mode works for both front and rear cameras. FM radio app is there and it works too. This is setting panel with colored icons, and this is the search bar at top. First we have network and internet tab. Everything about network is great. 2G, 3G, 4G, 4G VoLT works. Wi-Fi is also working without any issues. This is the Bluetooth tab. Pairing with devices is easy. There is no issue with audio or video playback, be it with calls, loudspeaker or when connected to the Bluetooth. There is a apps and notification tab with recently opened apps on the top. Next you have notification settings defaults app, where you can change the defaults app for various services and special app access. Under battery tab, there is a battery saver mode and you can turn it on automatically at any percentage of your choice, and sadly in Android Pie adaptive battery is not there. You can enable battery percentage on the status bar and below that you can find the battery stats. Next, under display tab, you have brightness level, night light works, adaptive brightness have no issues, sleep timer, phone size, display size, ambient display which is working, double tap to wake works by default, and under device theme, you can set it to automatic based on wallpaper or you can force it to dark or light, and the theming applies to notification and quick settings, volume slider and app drawer only. This is the sound tab and there is a separate slider for call volume. About the volume slider, you have a new volume shadow. Here by default you can change the media volume and you can enable vibrate or silent mode within this volume slider. You can also enable vibrate mode by touching volume up and power button together at the same time. Under security and location, you can find fingerprint option. Setting up is easy and unlocks in about a second. You can also add a face unlock via smart lock, but you have to swipe up on the lock screen once the system detects your face. There is no digital well-being in this Android Pie ROM. I have tried installing this from APK Mirror, and if you ever try to install it from Google Play Store, it says your device isn't compatible with this. However, installing it from other sites won't help you to use this. No digital well-being for this ROM. Next to the system gestures, you have swipe fingerprint for notification, jump to camera and swipe up on home button, and all are working without any issue. Under developer options, this is an option called simulate display with cutout, which forces a notch display, and there are three options to pick. All sensors are working fine: accelerometer, gyroscope, magnetometer, light sensor, proximity. All sensors are working fine. GPS also works, but it will take time for a location lock and if you try it from indoors. About the benchmarks, Antutu version 7 score is 82,048, Geekbench score single core score is 880 and the multi-core score is 4379. Overall, it's a good ROM. So that's it. I hope you guys like it. Hit the like button if you find this video helpful. If you guys have any queries or if you have any issues while installing this ROM, do let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching and I see you guys next time.